I am taking away something from him. I agree. It is a loss for that person, but benefit for me. I agree with you. What I told you, prove to me why it is bad for me. It is bad for the person who has been probed. What I told you, prove to me why it is bad for me. I am logical, I am scientific. I agree it is bad for the person who has been probed. Tell me why it is bad for me, I will stop robbing. Yes, brother, loudly. Someone will rob me, will I like it? Very good. Brother, I am a big mafia. I have got 100 bodyguards and all of them are behind the stage. I am a big robber, I am not a small robber. For a small robber it is bad. Someone may rob you. I am a big mafia. I have got 100 bodyguards all behind, you know, all with AK-47. I am logical, I am scientific. I am a big robber. For small robbers it is not good. Somebody may rob you. So, why it is bad for me? Yes, brother.
Hello, my name is Naveen.
Why is robbing bad for me?
Because you will be bad for other people.
I'll be bad for other people. I agree with you, my son. Why it is bad for me? I agree.
Because your name is going to be bad.
My name is very good. Why it is going to be bad? I'm telling you, my name gets bad, I'm no problem, as long as I'm benefiting. When I rob someone, maybe 100,000 dirham, if I rob, I can go to a 5-star hotel, I can see a movie, I can enjoy, I can eat biryani. Easy money. Other people are, you know, slogging out. Me, I get easy money, you know, robbing is very easy. Anyone? Someone will say that the police will catch me. The police cannot catch me because the police is on my payroll. I have the ministers in my pocket. I have the police in my pocket. I'm a big robber. I'm a mafia. Most of the countries, the police and the ministers can be in your pocket. They're on my payroll. So therefore, whatever answer you give, in no way, and I've done this exercise in audiences larger than this, 50,000 people, 100,000 people, no one so far has been able to tell me one logical reason. I am a non-Muslim, very logical, very scientific. No one can prove to me why robbing is bad. You want to kill me? I have got guards. Before you kill me, my guards will kill you. Yes, brother.
What I think why it would be bad for you is because when you start robbing, you will be collecting a lot of wealth.
Very good.
That wealth, you'll be worried about keeping it safe. And that will take your sleep away, it'll take your safety away from your family, and it won't give you peace of mind. And when you lose your peace of mind, you lose everything.
Brother said, if you have too much of wealth, difficult to keep. You know, there are many wealthy people sitting here. Difficult to keep, very easy to keep. There are many banks here. Why? I won't keep in my pocket. You know, now you have got credit cards, you have got checkbook. For you, who's a small man, when you get 1,000 dirham, you're afraid my 1,000 dirham will go away. I'm a multi-billionaire. All these banks and all, for me, is very safe. If I keep in the bank and everything, lot of profit, lot of interest. Brother, for small people to keep 1,000 dirham, they are worried. For me, I'm a billionaire.
But then again, you'll be worried about banks losing all the money with the recession. And these are natural calamities.
Brother is saying that if I keep it in the bank, recession, I'll own the bank. The banks have no problem. What do you know that even in recession, it's not only in bank, you can keep in wealth, you can keep in real estate. It is one option I've given you. You can keep in shares, everything. If the recession goes down again, it will come up. Dubai has gone down again, Dubai will come up. Yeah. It's going to come up. It will take 4-5 years. I'm so big, I've got no problem.
Then there's no answer to that.
Yes. No answer, I will give you the answer. I agree with you. There is no logical reply why robbing is bad, why raping is bad, why cheating is bad. Now, we turn the sides. You are the non-Muslim, robber, logical, scientific. I am a Muslim now. I, as a Muslim, I agree with you that logically, to prove robbing is bad is very difficult, except What I'll do first, I'll prove to that person the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I've given the talk, is the Quran God's word? It's for 2 hours. I don't intend giving the talk here. In that talk, I've proved logically, scientifically to the non-Muslims with the help of the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exists. After I've proved to him the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 40, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is never unjust in the least degree. The non-Muslim will tell me, you're talking about Allah, I believe in him. But you are saying that Allah is not unjust. I want to know and ask you this question. I do agree with you that for a person who's robbing, he would enjoy it. But if the same evil is done to someone who's close to him, will he like it? If suppose someone robs his father, will you like it? And the answer is no. Someone robs his uncle, will you like it? The answer is no. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just, there is so much of injustice done in this world. There are many robbers, we know they are robbing, yet they live a luxurious life. They have mansions, they have palaces, and they die, and everything is over. The reply is given in the glorious Quran, in Surah Mulk, chapter number 67, verse number 2. Allazi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. It's Allah who has created death and life to test which of you is good in deeds. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 185, Kullu nafsin zaiqatul maut. Every soul shall have a taste of death. And the final recompense will be on the day of judgment. Whosoever is saved from the hellfire and enters the garden, the paradise, he has achieved the objective of this world. For this world is goods and chattels of deception. So Allah says, the final recompense is only on the day of judgment. That means only believing in Allah is not sufficient. One of the pillars of Iman is, besides believing in Allah and the prophets and the books and the angels and the Qadr, is to believe in life after death. Without life after death, only believing in Allah is not sufficient at all. Therefore, one of the pillars of Iman is Akhirah, life after death. And we know that there are many robbers who are powerful. There are many thieves who are powerful. Mafias are powerful. Some of them get arrested. Some of them get punished in the world. Many of them go unpunished. So what kind of a test is this? So I will tell this rich person who's a robber, who's powerful, I agree with you, you'll enjoy in this world, you'll sleep peacefully, easy earning, but what about the Akhirah? What about life after death? There has to be a life after death. Only logically, without life after death, the life in this world cannot be justified. When we talk about justice, for example, you might have heard of Hitler. He incinerated 6 million Jews. Today, if you arrest him, what punishment can you give? If Hitler was arrested by the police, what punishment could the law give him of this world? Maximum one death. What about the balance 5,999,999 people he killed? You can only justify one death. But in the Akhirah, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse 56, that as to those who reject our signs, we shall cast them in the hellfire. And as often as their skins are roasted, we shall give them fresh skin so that they shall feel the pain. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to incinerate, burn Hitler 6 million times, he can do it. If Allah wants to burn him 12 million times, he can do it in the Akhirah. In this world, whatever your police catches, you can maximum compensate for one death. That's the reason, logically, and to justify that robbing is bad, raping is bad, bribing is bad. There has to be something like Akhirah. There has to be life after death. Without life after death, only believing in God is not sufficient. Only believing in Allah will not justify why robbing is bad, why raping is bad, why bribing is bad, except with the concept of Akhirah, as Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse number 185, kullu nafsin zaiqatul maut. Every soul shall have a taste of death. The final recompense is in the day of judgment.